Joining us now in Studio B is the man of the hour, Jeff Judkins, one of our favorites. Coach, we're thrilled for you. Number 7 seed taking on Auburn. What'd you think of the initial results?
I really thought it was very positive for us. We felt as a staff that we would be between 6 and 10. And we kind of thought 7 would probably be the most, you know, one we thought we'd probably be playing. And so to see that be 7th, you start looking at what teams that would be the 10th. We've in the past, and we've played now our last 2 years, we've been in the NCAA Tournament, we've played somebody from the SEC, which is a 10th seed. So we kind of have a good idea of what to expect.
Now, you have a following, and a good one, in the Bay Area of BYU fans. And you kind of put out the plea to, hey, show up, support the team in Stanford. In fact, right. you also called out Steve Young. Have you reached out to Steve?
No, I haven't. I just see him on TV all the time, and he's doing a lot of things with ESPN. And I know he's busy, but it'd be really nice if he could kind of come and bring a lot of people with him. It'd be fun for our team.
Well, Steve Young now joins us on the Deseret First Credit Union Hotline. So, Steve, are you going to go to the game or what?
Coach, this is great. Palo Alto's going to come out in power, man. We're going to be there Saturday. This is exciting.
You're kidding.
Come on.
Yeah.
Come on. This is big. And look, you know, Stanford's been a powerhouse for years and years in women's basketball, and you're coming to Zion, man. Way to go.
Well, if you're showing up, we're going to be pretty pumped. I know my team will for sure. But we're excited to go back and play there. Of course, you said Stanford is a beautiful place and campus. But we're going to focus on basketball mostly.
Steve, you're going to rally troops, right, man?
Coach, we'll be small, but we'll be loud, all right?
Okay, that's all that matters. It's not the volume, it's the noise. That's what it is. Thank you so much. That'd be cool to see you, Steve.
Steve.
Hey, Coach, you're the best.
Thanks for the time, man, and I'm sure we'll look forward to seeing you in California on Saturday.
Look forward to it. You guys are the best.
Got it.
Thank you.
Steve Young on the Deseret First Credit Union Hotline. Deseret First, your values, your timeline, your financial future. He's going.
You bring something up, and, BYU takes care of it. I like it. You know, when we got that call, the first thing I thought is, hey, can we get him to come to the game? Because last time we did very well in the tournament, we were in L.A., we were eating, and that's when we saw Magic Johnson, and my team went crazy.
That's right.
So, hopefully we can get Steve to come to dinner with us. My team will go crazy.
Oh, now you're getting picky. First it was the game. Now it's dinner, too?
Well, we'll see. I'm sure he won't pass on a free meal.
Exactly. That's a very, very calculated and well-calculated move, Coach.
Okay, so do you like the seating, the location, the opponent? Do you feel like this is all suitable to winning? Because that's the point. You're going there to win.
Yes. Yes, I think as you look at the whole – scenario where we are. We're playing a team that they're real quick and they're going to press us and put a lot of pressure on us. If we can handle that, we're going to be all right. And I do have a good guard line. So that's our strength, and hopefully they'll be able to do that. Second, what you mentioned, the location means something. Because when you fly across the country and all those things, the time zone, everything is just different. And then the third thing is, we have played there before, at least I have as a coach. I kind of know the atmosphere, and hopefully we'll get some fans and be able to have that opportunity to have a little bit more of not just a totally road game. Like we went to Tampa, we had probably 30 people, Hopefully we'll get double that, triple that, which we should, and it should be good for my team. And we match up well in that bracket. And that's another thing that you have to look at.
Jeff Judkins, the head basketball coach for BYU Women's Hoops, with us on BYU Sports Nation after Selection Monday. They are a 7 seed taking on Auburn this Saturday in Stanford, California. Okay, Coach, you find out earlier than anticipated after the bracket is leaked. Where were you when you found out who you were playing and where you were going?
Well, I have assistant coaches that are really on top of this, and we got done with practice, and we were going to meet and just talk about where we think we might be and who might be some teams and what we need to do and how we want to prepare for tonight. Once you hear it, the assistant coaches have to work so hard to get all the film, everything ready to go, So when I come in today, we've got an idea of what's going on. And so we talked about that, and then all of a sudden Ashley walks in my office and says, hey, Coach, there's something got leaked, and they got us picked here, and she showed me. And I'm going, wow, if that happens, that's pretty exciting. And then we're talking about it, and all of a sudden we hear that ESPN's going to make an announcement. So then I knew then it was a real deal. And so, you know, our team, we called our team and hurried to get them down here so that they could see what's going on. Because, you know, this is part of it. Part of it is the excitement of going to the tournament. It's not everything, but you work long and hard all season for this opportunity. It's kind of like Christmas, you know. Your parents, you know, you got Christmas already, and then it comes an hour earlier than what you think, you know. It's kind of like that.
Exactly.
But our team was excited, and it was good to get them all there. They all knew too, because, you know, this social media stuff, I mean, you know, I'm not into that, but they are, and it's just a great thing.
You didn't give us another Juddy face. In fact, you tried the opposite.
I tried the opposite.
And you already knew anyway. I did. So you stand, and we just saw it a second ago, but for our listeners, you stood up. So here's Juddy face from 2016. You're just staring. Everyone's excited, and you're like, and that made the NCAA tournament broadcast too. So this one, you stood up and got excited. You were trying to be the anti Juddy face.
You know, I was excited because I think nobody thought we would do it. Nobody thought that we could have this young team and come together and play as a team and everybody get better, and not just the players. You know, my coaching staff did a great job this year. A lot of teaching, a lot of individual work that nobody sees except for you see on the floor. And to be able to have all that, it was pretty special for us.
It'll be 10 days between games. What are the pros and cons of that type of layoff?
The pros are your players that played a lot of minutes get some serious rest, which you well know my three guards have averaged over 35 minutes a game. So for them, this was a blessing to rest. The negative part of it is rhythm. And you're the whole season, you're used to playing so many games at so many days and all that. You see it in the NBA all the time. They play all these crazy games in the playoffs, and they play two games a week or three games at max, and it gets them off. Well, the same thing happens with us. The nice thing about it is most all the women team are going through the same thing. We played most of our tournaments for way early, so we're not waiting for the last. And so we all have to balance it out. It's funny, I've heard from a couple of coaches, and they're asking me, what have you done for this 10 days? And, you know, we did take some time off. You know, Wednesday we took time off. Thursday we met. Some of the players shot. Friday we practiced hard. Saturday I gave them off. I gave them two good days to rest. Yesterday we went really hard. Today we'll go our normal way.
How do you've taken two teams of the Sweet 16. How do you feel like this team is prepared for the NCAA tournament for what you hope will be something memorable?
This team is really balanced. To go to the tournament, you have to have balance in your team. And what I mean by that is we have the guard play. We can go small. If we run into a team that has size and goes inside, I have enough depth with my inside presence to guard that. If we go against a team that's kind of in between, that's got two good bigs, I can do that. So this is where the team is special, is I have a lot of things that I can change my team up. Now, the Sweet 16 team, we went last. We had two really, really good bigs, and then we had Ashley Garfield as our backup. That was it. We had three bigs totally. And so it affected us when we got to UConn. We got in foul trouble. It was really tough to really deal with that. This year, you know, I've heard my assistant, Dan was on the radio, and heard him say, and he's right. He was talking about how our bigs don't get a lot of credit. It's our guards that score all the points. Our bigs were solid this year defensively and offensively. They've gotten better. Sarah's improved. Chalet has gotten a lot better. Jasmine's been a big plus. Babalu, I think people see her potential. You haven't even seen really Mal and Sig, who are working really hard. Both of them can shoot the ball really well. So we have some really good bigs, which we're kind of excited about, thinking they're going to get better.
Ah, yes. Well, the immediate future now includes the NCAA tournament, and that's exciting, as well as what's to come after this season. Coach, congratulations. Let's give you all the BYU Sports Nation karma we can muster up.
Yeah, so much mustering right now.
To take it to Stanford and hang out with Steve Young, enjoy that dinner, and then go and beat Auburn.
Hey, thanks a lot, guys. And we really appreciate all the coverage that we've had so far. And the tournament was great, seeing BYU, seeing you guys down the whole time. And what a great tournament. It really turned out to be special for BYU.
Absolutely.
Well, good luck Saturday.
Thanks.
And you can listen to the game on BYU Radio, 3:30 Eastern as well. So don't forget.
Yeah, we got Greg doing it.
Yeah, take care of him out there.
That's right, yeah. Man.
Take care of him.
You thought Greg was going to be the biggest celebrity. Now it's Steve.
Now it's Steve, yeah, that's right.